do you have to pay your medical bills from your settlement? Many times, yes. Let me explain how it works. Most of the time, people will treat, if they have an injury case, either through their health insurance or through their PIP insurance, if it's a car accident, or through what's called a letter of protection. If you treat through your health insurance, then whatever payments your health insurance makes to medical providers, they have a right of subrogation, which is just another way of saying they have a right to be reimbursed out of any eventual recovery that you make from a third party. So if you use health insurance to pay for treatment for injuries you sustained in an accident, and then eventually we get a settlement for you, then we're gonna have to deal with the health insurance lien at that point. Now in practice, we'll call up the health insurance lien subrogation specialist and negotiate that lien down as low as possible as we can for you, but we're gonna have to deal with it. PIP insurance provides $10,000 in insurance benefits through your own insurance company that can be used to pay for medical treatment after a motor vehicle crash. If you go to a doctor within the first 14 days, there's some other conditions, things like that. In my experience, most people involved in a motor vehicle crash who begin using their PIP benefits, whether it's with the emergency room, the chiropractor, MRI facilities, that PIP benefit gets exhausted and reaches that limit of $10,000 faster than you would expect. And then what happens is the doctors continue to treat you under what's called a letter of protection. Or if you don't have health insurance or car insurance, then we'll help get you to a doctor who will treat you under a letter of protection. A letter of protection is simply an agreement that you sign, the doctor signs, and our office signs, saying they'll provide whatever medical treatment you need, but then at the end of your case, once we make a recovery for you, we have to settle up with the doctors for their bills at that point. So, if you have treated through a letter of protection, that is a legal agreement, and we have no choice but to then deal with those medical bills at the time of your settlement. We'll again try to negotiate those bills down as low as we can for you, but at the time of your settlement, you'll get a final closing statement from our office that spells out exactly where every single penny in your case is going, including what the doctor's bill was, how much they reduced it by, how much they were paid already, how much their outstanding balance is, and how much they've agreed to accept as payment to satisfy that. And then we pay them out of the settlement funds. The only way that I can think your medical bills would not have to be addressed at the time of a settlement or out of a settlement would be if you paid yourself for your medical treatment out of your own pocket, which is extremely rare. Most people, like I said, either use health insurance, motor vehicle insurance, or a letter of protection, or a combination of some or all of those aspects. I can't think of a client in well over 20 years who has actually just dug into his or her own pocket and paid cash for medical treatment. Some people may pay cash for acupuncture or massage, things like that. And if you've paid for it, then obviously that doesn't have to come out of any settlement at the end of your case. So hope that answers your question. If I didn't, feel free to call me at 1-800-TRIAL-PRO or chat with us through our website at trialpro.com.